Will the interest you pay on your mortgage save you big bucks at tax time? Or is it just another tax break for America's wealthy? Hello and welcome to Practical Personal Finance, where you get the information you need to understand and succeed with money. I'm Andrew Scheer, and one of the first things that comes to my mind when it comes to homeownership and taxes is the mortgage interest tax deduction. Today, I'm going to explain what the mortgage interest tax deduction is, tell you about the requirements to qualify for it, and help you understand whether or not it will affect your tax bill. Make sure you stick around until the very end when I'll tell you my thoughts on this well-known deduction. Before we get started, do me a favor and give this video a thumbs up. And if you're new around here, hit that red subscribe button. You're about to learn something new about money. First, let's tackle the question, what is the mortgage interest tax deduction? To answer that, it's important to understand what a tax deduction is in general. A tax deduction is a specific amount of money that you subtract from your annual income before you calculate the amount of tax you owe. So if your income was $50,000 per year and you qualified for a $10,000 tax deduction, you would take $50,000 and subtract $10,000, and you would wind up with $40,000 in taxable income. This is the amount that you would use to calculate how much you owe in taxes. And because taxes are calculated as a percentage of your taxable income, a tax deduction will save you some money come tax time. If you're interested in learning more about tax deductions and how they're different from tax credits, I made a video where I compare the two of them with a bunch of easy-to-understand examples. Link is down below. Now that you have a good understanding of what a tax deduction is, let's talk specifically about the mortgage interest tax deduction. When you make your mortgage payment every month, there are two primary components, principal and interest. The principal component goes toward the amount you borrowed for your mortgage. The interest component is an extra fee you need to pay your mortgage lender for the privilege of borrowing their money. At the beginning of each year, your mortgage lender will send you a special tax form called Form 1098. This form will include the total amount of interest fees you paid on your mortgage in the previous year. And as long as you meet certain qualifications, which we'll talk about next, those interest fees are 100% tax deductible. In other words, you can subtract the amount you paid in mortgage interest from your income to reduce the amount of taxes you owe. In addition to the interest fees you paid throughout the year, there are several other fees you may have paid that could also be deductible as part of the mortgage interest tax deduction. If you paid an extra fee because one of your mortgage payments was late, that extra amount could be deductible. So could any penalties you may have had to pay if you paid off your mortgage early. And if you purchased or refinanced your home in the past year, you may have prepaid some interest in the form of mortgage points. That money could be deductible as well. You might even be able to deduct interest on a home equity loan or a line of credit, provided it was used for certain specific purposes. The point is, you're not necessarily limited to what you paid in interest every month. So have that conversation with your tax professional about your specific situation. All right, now that you've got a good understanding of what the mortgage interest tax deduction is, let's talk about how you can qualify to take that deduction. Here's where things start to get a little bit interesting. The first requirement is that you own your home and that you have a loan that's secured by that home. And although this part seems pretty straightforward, the IRS has gone to great lengths to define what exactly constitutes a home. This is the kind of thing I just love learning about when it comes to taxes. The IRS tells us that a home must have sleeping, cooking, and toilet facilities. So it doesn't matter if it's a single family home, a condo, a mobile home, a shack in the woods, or even a boat. As long as you've got an area to sleep, an area to cook, and an area to do your business, you're good. Now, for the loan part, the majority of people just have the traditional mortgage that was used to purchase a property. But as I hinted at earlier, you can also qualify with a home equity loan, a home equity line of credit, aka a HELOC, or a construction loan, as long as you meet some other specific requirements. The second requirement has to do with when you got your mortgage and how much your mortgage is for. Over time, the federal government has been slowly clamping down on the amount people qualified to deduct for their mortgage interest. If you got your mortgage prior to October 13, 1987, and for some reason you haven't paid it off yet, there aren't any limits. You can deduct the full amount of interest you paid. If you got your mortgage between October 14, 1987 and December 15, 2017, you're limited to the interest paid on up to $1 million of mortgage debt. So if you've got a mortgage for more than $1 million, you can only deduct the interest paid on the first million of it. $1 million or less, you're good. And finally, if you got your mortgage on December 16, 2017 or later, the limit was cut from $1 million to $750,000. So for a mortgage of more than $750,000, you can only deduct the interest paid on the first $750,000 of it. Less than $750K, and I suspect this covers the vast majority of people, you can deduct all of your interest. The third and final requirement is that the mortgage is on your primary residence or your second home. Your primary residence is where you spend the majority of the year living. Pretty easy to understand. If you're fortunate enough to own a second home, there are special rules about how often you have to occupy that home, depending on whether it's rented out for part of the year or just sits empty when you're not there. And if you're one of the few people who owns more than two homes, I'm sorry to let you know that mortgages on those additional homes would not qualify. Finally, let's talk about whether or not the mortgage interest tax deduction will affect you. And what you need to know about the mortgage interest tax deduction is that in order to use it, you're going to need to itemize your deductions on your taxes. What this means is that when you file your taxes, you would add up your mortgage interest and any other deductions like charitable donations and medical expenses to get your full deduction. The alternative to itemizing your deductions is electing to use something called a standard deduction, a deduction that's been predetermined by the government and is available to everyone. You want to choose whichever method gives you the larger deduction, which will in turn give you a larger reduction on your taxable income and the tax you owe. So what it all comes down to is whether your itemized deductions, including your mortgage interest, exceed the standard deduction. 5 or 10 years ago, it was usually a slam dunk. The standard deduction was around $6,000 if you were single and $12,000 if you were married. So if you had a decent-sized mortgage, the itemized deductions would win every time. But that all changed in 2018, when the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act went into effect. The standard deduction amounts were essentially doubled to about $12,000 for single filers and about $24,000 for married couples. To give you an idea of how this compares to mortgage interest, let's say you were married with a $500,000 mortgage at a 4% interest rate. Multiply $500,000 by 4% and you wind up with $20,000. So even with that massive mortgage where you're paying over $1,600 per month in interest alone, you're still going to end up taking the standard deduction unless you've got some other big deductible expenses. The Tax Cuts and Jobs Act accomplished the goal of simplifying tax filing by making the standard deduction high enough to be the best option for the vast majority of Americans. The only people who are going to itemize their deductions and use the mortgage interest tax deduction at this point are the wealthiest Americans. The people who can afford to take out a mortgage of $750,000 or more. And for that reason, I feel that the mortgage interest tax deduction is out of step with its original intentions, to help lower and middle class Americans realize the American dream of owning the place they call home. What do you think of the mortgage interest tax deduction? Should we keep it around, or should we eliminate it now that the average American has no use for it? Let me know in the comments. If you've ever wondered how tax brackets work, click right here for a simple, easy to understand explanation. It's one of my favorite videos. And if you're not already a PPF subscriber, click right here to take your money game to the next level. As always, thanks for watching. I'm Andrew Scheer, and I'll see you next time.